I've had a lot of people on Facebook and YouTube ask me, after they seen that video of me riding through the mud down at the pig property, how I was going to clean the bike, and you know, a few of them wanted to know how things held up components wise to the mud. So all in all, it held up great in my opinion. I haven't found any issues yet. I mean, maybe some minor things, but I'm going to show you a couple spots that I'd like some suggestions on from you guys, maybe a better way to protect some, like some of the cables and things like that. So I'm going to show you what I think. Now, how I cleaned it, honestly, I just basically took a water hose and just knocked all the mud, you know, all the thick mud off of the bike. And then I just took some cleaner, there's some mean green cleaner and some shop towels, and just started wiping down the spots I could hit. Now you can see, you know, obviously underneath there was spots I didn't hit. Now one of the things I was wanting everybody to possibly give me a suggestion on is this right here. You can see out of that controller all those cables. I guess I was never observant enough to notice how they come out of that controller. So my worry is the way I ride, is that something that can get hit, you know, going over some sticks or a stump or something like that. I know the chain ring should guard it, but I'm not sure. So if anybody's got any suggestions of what they've done with that portion, or if they have any ideas, feel free to let me know. Really, the only place I seen that did not like the mud was right here on the kickstand. I actually lubricated it. I sprayed some WD-40 in there because this was where that grinding was happening, and it was acting like it didn't want to come forward when I would use the kickstand. Now you can hear now there's nothing really in there. But I did lubricate that. So that really probably, as far as the bike goes, that's the only spot that I seen that didn't like the mud. Now on a good note, this is the plug for the motor. And I have not, you know, I did a little, maybe a little cleaning on the top, but as far as taking it loose or anything, I did not do anything. And you can see how well that did, how clean it is. It didn't get any water or mud in the plug itself, so that is very good. The crank itself, very quiet, it doesn't grind or anything. The derailleur, it held some mud in it, a little worse for wear on some spots. You can see the chain's kind of hokey there, but all in all, it held up pretty good. I'm still going to clean it. You can see it's got a lot of stuff still trapped in here. Now these brakes I actually put on since that ride. So these are the cabled hydraulic brakes. I've ridden around with them. I probably got 10, 12 miles on them so far, and I think they're excellent. There is a pretty good, let me get out of the light here, mud getting up there in the front, I don't know what you would call it, in where the forks attached to the neck of the bike. It does get some mud up in there. I'm going to have to figure out how to get that out. As far as the shocks go, I mean, there's nothing rough. They're real smooth. They still seem to work. I've ridden around, like I said, a little bit after I put the new brakes on. I haven't noticed any grinding or anything actually anywhere on the bike. Nothing, you know, if you know how that, where it gets real gritty or in bearings sound, I haven't heard anything like that. One of the things that I thought was pretty good is how the battery did as well in the mud test. You can see it got a little bit in there, not too bad. I mean, that might have been from me taking it off to recharge it. Looking at the connection on the bike itself, you know, pretty clean. Very impressed. Now, after I took the bike apart, I took the front wheel off, and I noticed it's got this rubber dust cap kind of seal, and I did pull it off already, but I looked underneath it, and it's really clean underneath there. It did a very good job of holding all that mud out. Now here's the opposite side of the rim. I haven't had this side off yet, so we can all be surprised. But looking at it here, if I can get the seal out, hopefully I can get it back in there. Well, it looks pretty clean. I don't know if you've seen that or not. It looks as clean as the other side here. There we go. So these guys right here, these seals are going to be very important. So when I put them back on, I have to make sure I get them on there good, because I am going to be back down there in that mud before you know it. So I haven't done anything to the back wheel. I haven't, you know, other than, you know, with the hose washing it off. I've just disconnected it. Now you can see how nice and clean inside the motor cable is. Perfect. Spinning the gears, that was me there. No grinding, nothing like that that I can hear. Now there is some gunk here that I'm going to have to clean up. So this would be one spot I would probably watch. If you're going to be riding like I do in the mud and things, you're going to have to pull that back tire off and really inspect this section. Looking at the other side, about the same. They don't have the seal in there like they do on the front wheel. It might be nice if they did have that. But I don't see anything that looks very scary as far as not sealed. I mean, the motor looks like it's sealed very well. I've seen some videos of people actually trying to take the motor out, and those Phillips head screws are very hard to get out. So I think the factory seals it pretty good. The discs on the brakes, they look like they did all right. You know, you can see obviously where the pad rubs, but they're not rough or anything like that.
All in all, the bike did great. I couldn't ask for better. For the money you paid versus, you know, the Rambo bikes and the other really high dollar hunting bikes you have out there, I think this one definitely holds its own, especially for the price point. You know, other than the concerning, you know, maybe the cables, I'd like to see maybe how some of the other bikes protect their controller and protect their cables. But as far as the components go, the motor, everything, it held up really well. Now, you know, I'll be putting it through its paces more and more, you know, as time rolls on, and we'll keep looking at it, and I'll keep you posted. If there's anything that fails on me, I'll definitely post it to you guys and tell you what's going on. Well, I appreciate you watching. And I'll keep posting videos, and you know, please subscribe. Definitely leave some comments. Let me know other things you'd like to see. I'm working on a few new accessory racks to go on the bike. Maybe something for fishing poles and tackle boxes. Gonna work on a different game cart, maybe a more permanent game cart. So just send me a comment or an email, or, you know, tell me, hey, you'd like to check this out, or, you know, just get with me if you got any ideas that, you know, you need help with. So, all right, thank you.